Good morning, students. Once again, welcome back to your own expertise biology with Yasmin, and here is your Yasmin. So today we are going to do one of the chapter of science of biology, chapter number that is living organisms and their surroundings. So in this chapter we have studied many of the subtopics. So let us proceed further. Yesterday we had done the adaptations. We have studied about the definition of adaptation and about the terrestrial adaptation, about the aerial adaptation, about the terrestrial adaptation and different forms. So now and also we had studied about the adaptation of terrestrial in desert and that to implants. Implants, what were the adaptations we had seen? Just revise once again, children. We had seen about they have got the adaptations in their roots, their leaves, their stems, they are deep rooted. Their stem is very fleshy, known as succulent, and their leaves are modified into spines. Yes. So now we are going to move further. That is the adaptation of the animals in the desert. So what are the adaptations of animals in the desert? Animal life. Many desert animals and insects survive the Many desert animals and insects survive the heat of the day by staying in burrows. As we had seen yesterday in last chapter, in the last session, that in the desert area the temperature is very very high. It's too hot there. So it's very difficult for any life to survive there. So the animals that are staying there, they in order to fight this high temperature or heat, they stay during the daytime in the burrows. So the many desert animals and insects survive the heat of the day by staying in burrows deep inside the sand during the day. So deep inside the sand in burrows, they stay during the daytime in order to survive in that high temperature, that is the hot weather. Now they come out only at night when it is cool. As we all know, during the night, as the day passes away, the weather becomes cooler. So these animals, they come outside their burrows when there is night. And few of the examples of the animals are the rat and snake. So in the daytime, the rat and the snake in the desert area, they stay in the burrows in the desert to protect themselves from the high temperature or the hot, and then they come out of the burrows in the evening. Now let us proceed further. And best example of the animals in the desert area is the camel. So particularly we study about the adaptations in the body of the camel to fight the high heat or to survive or to adapt in the desert area. A camel has several adaptations to help it survive in a desert. As we studied yesterday also, all the adaptations in the plant in the desert area is to retain water in them, because they can't afford to lose water from their body parts, as the availability of water in that area is very very low. There is scarcity or shortage of water. So all the adaptations are such that they save or retain water in their body. Same here, all the adaptations in the body parts of the animal in the desert, that is the camel, is such that it retains water in its body. Now, first is, it has a hump. That hump means everyone knows the camel. It has a hump on its back. Yes, that fat is stored, and in the hump, what is stored? Fat. This provides it with food in times of shortage. So in the hump there is fat which helps it to survive when there is shortage of food. In that area they don't get easily food and water. So hump is around their back so that they can survive in the time when there is shortage of food. It can therefore live without food for several days. So children, is it possible for us to stay without food for many days? But the structure of the structural adaptation of camel is such that its hump is around its back so that it can survive without food for many days, which is not possible for us because we don't have the adaptations. Okay,
now it can drink a very large quantity of water at a time and then stay without water for a long time.
As everyone knows, as we all know, that in desert area there is shortage of water. Yes, there is lots of shortage of water. So as there is shortage of water, they only drink less amount of water at a time and then survive without water for a long period of time, which is again not possible for us or other mammals.
Now it excretes very little water in the form of urine.
Excrete means what? It gives out the waste. Excretion means to give out waste from our body. So again, it excretes very less water in the form of urine.
Okay? And besides, its dung is dry and it doesn't sweat.
Its dung, the dung that it gives out in the form of waste, is also very dry and it also doesn't sweat. Yes, we all the other mammals, they sweat. So by sweating, they give out the waste in the form of liquid from the body, which it's not there in camels.
And it does loses very little water from its body.
So all the adaptations you have seen were there to retain water in their body as there is shortage of water.
Now it is long legs that keeps its body away from the heat of the sun.
As we all know, the camels have long legs. Why they have long legs? So that their body doesn't touch the hot sand when they are walking on it. Okay? So because of the long legs, their body is away from the sun.
And its feet have long, large soles and are suitable for walking on soft sand.
Their feet, their sole of the feet, they have large soles, which makes it possible for it to walk on the sand. So, which is not possible for us because we are not having large soles. But in the legs of the camel, they have large soles, which makes them easy to walk on the soft sand. So in the adaptations, we had studied about the terrestrial habitat adaptation, and we have studied mainly about the plant animals of the desert. Now let us proceed about the adaptations in the plant animals of the polar and mountain habitats. Okay,
now these habitats are cold. See, everyone knows that mountain areas and the polar areas are colder
as temperature there is low. Okay, and so in these areas many a time you can see snow or snowfall.
These habitats are cold. The polar regions are covered with snow.
Everyone knows that polar areas are covered with snow.
And there may also be snowfall in mountain regions during the winter.
In this season, in the winter season, mostly in these areas, there is always snowfall. Okay? So it's not at all easy for everyone to survive in that area. So for the plant life or the animal life in those areas, their body structure is such that they show the adaptation in the body structure such that the animals have furry skin, thick skin, and the animals and the plants, they have such an adaptation in their leaves and their tree types so that the snow, they falls from their body, it doesn't stay there. Okay, because it's snow for them and the temperature is low. So now let us see about the plant life adaptation in the snowy area or in the polar area or the mountainous area. You can use any word.
So the trees growing on mountains are cone-shaped with sloping branches.
Cone-shaped means what? We know the cone of the ice cream, or cone-shaped, we can take an example of the cap of the clown in the circus. It's cone-shaped. So because of the cone shape of the tree, the ice, it slides down. The ice doesn't collect on it. Okay?
So the trees growing on mountains are cone shaped with sloping branches.
See, in other terrestrial areas, we can see the mango tree and all those things. Are the branches sloping? No. But here in the desert area, in the mountainous area or the polar area, the branches of the trees are sloping. Okay? So that the snow slopes down.
Many of them have sharp needle-like leaves.
They have sharp needle-like leaves. Many of the trees there.
example you can say pine. So what happens? This helps the snow to slide off easily. This needle-like structure or this cone-like structure helps the snow to slide down from it. If this doesn't happen, the branches would break because of the weight of accumulated snow on them. See, if this won't be the structure of the trees there, the cone shape or the leaves are of needle shape, so that this is adaptation is shown so that the snow doesn't accumulate or doesn't collect on it and it slides down. Or else, if the snow collects on the tree, the branches would break down because of the weight of the snow. Okay, so type of the questions that would be asked from this part is, what are the adaptations for the plants like in the polar or the mountainous habitats, and what I have taught in the few minutes back, from that the question that would be asked is, what is the adaptation of the animal of the desert area, and many questions would be asked from there, like why, what is the use of the hump of the camel? Why camels have got each and every feature can be asked as the reason why the camel has got long legs. Okay, so why they can stay without water for many days, and from here it could be asked why the plants, they are cone shaped or the leaf is needle like. These questions would be asked, could be asked for give reason. Any doubt, children? Okay, take a screenshot if you want.